This review will take a quick look at the DMZ that separates the two North Koreas. It's quite a DMZ, and it's guarded and fortified. And here's a little brief story about it, and I'll try to get the significant points in. One moment, please.
No regime and no nation should underestimate ever American resolve.
The United States, who is the ringleader of the division of our people and the prime obstructor to the reunification, should stop anti-North Korea sanctions.
For all of the tension, all of the intense rhetoric and provocative actions, they will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen. Rocket Man is on a suicide mission for himself and for his regime.
Whatever Trump expected, he will see a response above that. We will control the mentally deranged U.S. dotard with fire.
The standoff between nuclear North Korea and the rest of the world. There is one place where the U.S. and North Korea see eye to eye, or at least face to face. The demilitarized zone, the DMZ, marking the border between North and South Korea, and the armistice agreement struck to pause the Korean War.
I think we always operate at a higher level of tension than, say, the rest of the peninsula, just because it is a pretty strategically important area. And so based on what's going on outside of our area of operations, nothing really changes for us. We're always ready to follow the commander's intent of what the chain of command above us asks us to do. Everyone wants to avoid the worst possible scenario. And so even the propaganda, I would say, has been pretty minimal, and it hasn't been overly tense.
Just a few feet from here is North Korea. This is the DMZ, the demilitarized zone. On this side, the South Koreans, the U.S. control. Just a few feet from here, the North Koreans. There was a lot of communication between the two for many years. In fact, they had a phone they'd pick up, and they'd answer on the North Korean side. But they stopped answering in 2013. So now, South Korean troops come out every day. They stand here on point. And if there's a message to deliver, they go right to that line, that concrete barrier. That is the line with North Korea, toes to that concrete, and they yell the message to the North Koreans, at which point they're videotaped. That's the only communication back and forth.
From that building, we have a hotline. You can kind of see the wire draped across to North Korea. It's a ring-down phone. It works. And, you know, we test it four times a day.
So basically you pick it up, it rings there.
Yes, sir. They're just not answering it right now. We nicknamed it the Bat Phone because the State Department was up here one time, and I was talking to one of their delegation, and I just said Bat Phone like that. So she went back to Washington, D.C. and sent us the Batman sticker. So the Bat Phone it is. As a matter of fact, we're going to do the midday check right now.
All right. See? No, no answer.
No answer this time. I was kind of hoping they would answer for you, although my mom would never let me do it down. When they don't answer it, we have to come down here on the border here, as Captain was saying. We put toes on the border there, and we shout the messages at them. More times than not, they'll come down and video record the message that they're not getting by just answering the phone. So it makes sense to somebody in North Korea.
It's kind of a strange process, huh?
It is, yes, sir. Some of the stuff after 6.5 decades, we've reduced it to a very elementary level. And that's just to sustain this place as a place that is open for communication and dialogue. However, there haven't been general officer talks up here since 2009. There haven't been actual staff officer level talks since 2013. In front of you, you see the border is represented by these white stakes. It's called the MDL, or Military Demarcation Line. And you'll notice there's no fences on the border. There are no fences on this de facto border across the entire peninsula.
Enemy advances a bit, and
so we headed up here.
Yeah. So what is it, a song that we're supposed to like North Korea after we hear it? Or?
Absolutely, yeah. The oddly enough, they both had propaganda broadcasts from either side, and it stopped in 2004, but in 2015 there was a provocative landmine incident up here. and it blew off two of the 1st Rock Infantry Infantry Division soldiers' legs. And ever since then, both sides have been pumping the propaganda again. And it can be lovely music like this, or it can be the, you know, speeches, you know. Mm-hmm. And North Korea plays it about 20 hours a day.
20 hours a day.
On our side, we do about 2 or 3 hours a day. And it could be anything from news broadcast to K-pop. I stepped out one time, and they were playing Radio Free America, so I stepped out to Bon Jovi.
Wow. Tells the story. Those 1,500 artillery pieces aimed at Seoul are the main considerations and limitations to even small targeted U.S. military action in North Korea, which brings us back to the time-honored tension in the DMZ, the arcane maneuvers, the spectacle of both sides bringing tour groups to stare at the opposing country.
So they have a tour going on right now, and they're waving at us. And so what is that? I mean, like some...
There's just a commercial tour. It is very like... The kid speaks better English than I do.
Is that right?
Yeah. I think he had an American teacher.
And the blue buildings, built to straddle the border for negotiations that haven't been used for that purpose in more than 4 years.
In February of 2013, North Korea did their third nuclear test. And there was a whole bunch of sanctions laid on them. And so sort of protest to the sanctions, yeah, really. They just, you know, they were very verbose about ripping up the armistice and all the agreements that came after the armistice.
When was the last time the North Koreans were in here?
For this meeting, it was May of 2009. However, the North Koreans are in here every day, 5 or 6 days a week with tours. So much like we have in here right now, we lock the north side door and we'll bring visitors into this area.
So then if they come down, they lock the south side door and then it's their deal.
That's it. Yeah.
Hangs over President Trump's entire trip to Asia. So standing in North Korea, we'll be right back with special report after the break.
That's a quick look at the DMZ that separates North and South Korea. And it's a rather interesting border, and hopefully I got everything in here for a quick review, and that'll do it.